we're trying to understand how systems in the body go wrong. Firstly, we want to understand how they go right, and then secondly, how they can fail.
For me, medicine's like the ultimate mix of science and people skills. I don't think I'd like to do just pure science because there's not enough interaction with people, and I wouldn't like to do just pure humanities because there's not enough science.
A lot of people have, you know, epiphanies and things like that where they realise that medicine is a course for them. I think for me, it was a decision that I spent a lot of time thinking about.
We have 2 years of science-based learning, and then we do an extra third year, and then we go into our clinical studies.
The first part is an unashamedly scientific exploration of the basis of medicine. And that distinction, I think, is becoming increasingly rare in medical schools in the UK, or medical courses in the UK.
I really didn't know much about the different topics within medicine, but the first 3 years give you a chance to experience a bit of everything and then see what you like and then delve further into that.
My first year in medicine at Oxford was somewhat overwhelming, I would say, at the start.
When they realise it about halfway through the first term, that this is actually a big step up and the expectation is actually now on a different level entirely, not just for them but for everybody, you can see them sort of buckle down and say, right, I understand, I know what it is that's special about where I've come and what's going to be demanded of me.
There's so little time to learn all the stuff and to learn how you learn the stuff.
If you enjoy what you're doing, if you really do like medicine, then, you know, the workload doesn't become such a chore.
As a second year medic in Oxford, my typical week probably looks like about 15 to 20 hours of lectures and 3 tutes, and for each tute you'd be expected to write an essay or prepare a piece of work, so there's quite a lot of work involved.
Everybody has the opportunity to be in a primary research lab, to do a research project in a lab with groups that are at the cutting edge in the world in their fields, and I think that probably is one of the aspects that singles the course out as unique.
In the third year, it's a specialist year, so you get to pick your own research project in a field that you enjoy. And then secondly, you get to pick an option as well that you enjoy. So for example, I really liked the heart, so I picked a project that was related to that, and then I picked my option, which was related to that as well.
One of the things I think that I'm particularly excited about is the number of research publications that are now permanently part of the primary research list, literature in biomedical sciences, that have an Oxford undergraduate medical student as one of the authors.
The teaching is fantastic. We're given a lot of support, both in college and at a university level, and we're often taught by experts in their fields, which does mean that they're very often very passionate about what they do, which is great, but they give you loads and loads of information, nowhere near the amount that you could possibly learn.
There's a level of support that runs through the whole course, whether it's demonstrators in practicals, whether it's tutors in tutorials, that will make sure not only that all of the teaching that you need is available, but that the way you engage with it and the extent to which you understand is also being continuously reinforced. Collectively, the equipment that's available across the medical sciences division, across the university and in nearby institutions is pretty much unsurpassed anywhere.
The libraries in Oxford are fantastic, second to none, so you don't just have to work in your college library, you can work in the science library, in the Bodleian library, anywhere around Oxford, there's libraries everywhere.
What I would say is unique to Oxford is it's a kind of a facility. It's your college tutor who is really helpful. The advice that they give is priceless.
In terms of the overall delivery, of course, one of the uniquenesses is the tutorial system.
The tutorial system definitely took me a bit of time to settle into. I wasn't very vocal to begin with in shoots, and I just let a lot of the information wash over me and didn't really offer that much. And then we had a meeting with our tutor probably like halfway through the first term, and he kind of raised this as a point to me and said, you need to participate more, and I really made an effort.
One of the advantages of the Oxford system, of course, is that nobody who is feeling that they're lost in a particular subject can feel that way for very long without somebody knowing and being in a position to do something to help.
The fun part is that you get to go way beyond the lecture material, so you get to think about, you know, why do things happen?
So much of school learning is this is what you need to learn, go away and learn it, and there is that in medicine too at Oxford, but there's also a lot of this is what we're teaching you, do you think this is right, how can we tell that this is the truth, how do we know that what we're being told is correct?
A big thing about Oxford is to think outside the box, to be able to think on your feet, and these were things that I wasn't really taught during college, during my school life, so it's things that you pick up quickly during your tutorials here.
There are several occasions where we've actually rethought a current line of research based on conversations in tutorials.
Before I applied to Oxford, I'd heard a lot of myths about the university and then the course itself. So things like, you know, the ridiculous interview questions that you're asked, the insane amount of workload that medics get, and lastly, you know, I also kind of thought, I stereotyped the medics themselves as, you know, perfect applicants, you know, with ridiculously high BMAT grades and things like that. And it's sad because that nearly stopped me from applying to Oxford.
They were the first medicine interviews I'd ever had, so I was definitely very nervous, but I think that the support system that the colleges themselves put up, so all of the colleges employ some of their students to come and make it a relaxing, nice time, was really good, and in the end I ended up really enjoying my kind of interview experience.
I love to feel, even in an interview, that I've posed a question that's actually really made somebody think, that for a fraction of a second they've forgotten that they're in an interview. They've just been asked something that gives them a new perspective and has made them think. And you can see it in their eyes when that happens. And then you think, yes, you'll do.
At each college you have one clinical interview and one science-based interview. So the clinical interviews are like the interviews that you get at other universities. So they're like ethically based, you have ethical dilemmas, they're just trying to tell if you're an empathetic and caring person.
The evidence comes from talking to students about their experiences, about how they bring their knowledge to bear to particular circumstances where they've been talking to somebody who is unwell in a hospital, worried about something, a relative of somebody in a care home, wherever their experiences have taken them.
The science-based interviews are like nothing I'd ever come across before.
In my interview, I got something completely wrong. But because I'd spelled it out to them why I thought that, they said, okay, in your thought process, this is where you went wrong. This is the correct information, and then I could work it out.
I think the advice that I would give for that science-based interview is that it's not what you know, but it's how you apply what you know.
I think probably the biggest misperception is that we're in some way still not looking for the best, but looking for some arbitrary background experience or strange combination of requirements that really is just not the case.
And I had an email from my now tutor, the tutor for admissions from my college, and the subject line was your application to St Edmund Hall, and I was like, oh my goodness.
My tutor called me up and I thought this has got to be some kind of prank. at this stage, I don't have much idea of what kind of doctor I want to be, so what I want to specialize in. But I think that's the beauty of Oxford, is that it opens so many avenues for you.
We produce medical graduates who are equipped to start out the best that they can be, but to be equipped to continually evolve and develop.
You should give it your best shot, and you should look at your application as something where you have nothing to lose, but everything to gain.